Just as you mentioned that about having a guilty side of it, because you have to do something. Because maybe what I do is that when I eat, the thing which comes to my mind is that if I'm eating today, like suppose if I'm going to a wedding or a marriage or something, I know there will be nice food around. So what I do is that I like having those kachoris or biryanis or whatever I feel like having, and then I balance it out the next day with more of workout or with a better diet plan. Yes. So that's the way I do
See,
it.
this is the big learning for me, and this is something that I never understood. I always had a fatalistic attitude. You're fat, you're thin. So I'm fat, she's thin, and that's how it's going to be for the rest of my life. And the learning was that if you are short, I'm sorry, you will be short all your life, you can't be tall. But if you're fat, no matter how fat, you can always be thin. And this is, you're hearing it from Koyal herself. She's so petite, but she would compensate. And most people who are overweight don't get that. They don't compensate, right? And I confess, I've done some pretty ridiculous things to get into that dress for that D-day or for that D-date, whether it's a Thai papaya diet or whether it's a coconut water. The last one is an egg white diet. So is there something
I
that
was
you've
also
done
seeing the
pretty
papaya diet
drastic?
that you did, because I was reading the book, and there were so many different mix and match diet and the papaya diet, and finally you came to the champagne diet.
Yes.
Wow.
Finally, I came to the champagne diet. That's where I stopped. I said, this is it. This is my diet for life. So have you done something ridiculous, like a ridiculous diet to fit into that particular dress for a particular scene or a song or something like that?
Not exactly, because I remember I after my class 10 exams, because of my study routine and because of everything, I would be studying and I would be eating, because at that point of time the diet thing was definitely not there in my mind at all. And then I would be eating, and then class 11 I was really fat. I was really, really fat. And it is fat is the term, not being healthy. I was really obese. And my
Checking with your mom.
mom No, seriously, honestly speaking. And then I remember in my class there was this one girl who called me with a name, and I was thinking, is she calling me? And then I couldn't really understand that, because I turned back and I was thinking whether she's calling somebody else with that name. And I thought, maybe. And then she said that, it's you, Rukmini. I'm sorry, that's my formal name. So it's you, Rukmini, come, come, come. And I'm like, okay, excuse me. And then I realized that I've actually gained weight at that point of time when I was in class 11. And then I realized even more seeing the mannequins with nice fitted dresses. And at that point of time, when you know that generally what I felt because I was obese and because I was on the healthier side at that point of time, class 11, so I could understand that you have to, cover that bulge up with a better fitted dress, or you have to think about the shape of the costume so that you look nice.